policemen, judges, yeah. politicians, okay? They wanted alcohol just as much as everyone else, okay? And so somebody had to supply it. Alcohol. It couldn't be an official supplier, okay? It had to be somebody else. And so who was the supplier?
Capone.
Well, and organized crime, okay? and what happened was that, you know, prior to the Prohibition, organized crime was pretty small. It was localized, it was in little gangs here and there, and pretty much what they controlled were gambling and prostitution,
yeah.
which had its, you know, it had its market, but now you opened it up to this huge market
right.
that everybody wanted alcohol.
Everybody wanted to keep.
And so organized crime became this really big thing because of all the money they made in that 15-year period yeah. basically selling alcohol. That's where they funded like them for the rest of time. Okay? They made tons of money on alcohol. And in fact, you know, when people were still protesting in 1933 to prevent the end of Prohibition, you know, organized crime was funding them, okay? Because they didn't want Prohibition to end either, because they were making a ton of money on it, okay? And if it went back to where, you know, people could sell alcohol legitimately, it cut out some of their revenue, you know, but by that time they were kind of pretty much on the path, and then they kind of, the next thing they came into were drugs, was that in the South, you had people who had stills, okay, and they were back in the hills, they had these stills, they were making moonshine, mm-hmm. and they needed a delivery system to get the moonshine from back up in these hills to the buying public, okay. And, you know, they needed a delivery system that could outrun any of the officials. Right. And so they hired these guys who got their cars and souped up their cars and made them really fast so that they could deliver, you know, they were the drivers. The drivers would deliver the alcohol, okay? And they had these cars that they, you know, modified to be a lot faster than normal. And after a while, these drivers started saying, well, who's the fastest among us? So they started to have races. That's how NASCAR started. If you look at the early drivers in NASCAR, they were people who were drivers for these still guys.